about 8.5. That is dealing with the trapezoid, right? You're good. You don't have to duck. Could have waved the camera, said hi, mom. Any other questions we didn't cover? I know. Yeah.
I just had a question. So for like number one. Would K and J be supplementary?
K and J be supplementary. I think they would have to be.
Okay.
Yeah, because you had 50 and 50, so that's the 100. They have to be 36. Yeah. Wait, hang on. When did that work? Hang on. Let me try that one more time. Let's just double check that. Like what you're saying. So, shh. That's 50. That's 50. Then I know that all the angles. So I know that these have to be the same, but would that and that be supplementary to each other? Let's see if it would happen. I don't know. So I know that 360 minus 100 is going to be 260. And if I divide that in half, that's 130. So 130, 130. Yes, it would be then. But obviously here to here isn't supplementary or here to here. But
okay, so you shouldn't just go straight from 180 minus 50 to get that angle. You should
realize if this one was 50, you'd know that this one has to be 50. And then go from there. Any luck?
No.
Oh, shoot. Yeah.
So for number five. Is it yes? Because you can't prove that the other side are.
Ooh, let's see. Number five. You have this. Okay, so determine if each quadrilateral must be a trapezoid. So the trapezoid means we have to have one set of parallel sides where those parallel sides don't have to be the same, right? But if they happen to be the same, that still could work. Okay, so let's think about things that we know are in place. If I extended these lines, then and if I extended these lines, so those, so I want to see if I can make them parallel. And are they really alternate interior angles, though?
For
the top and the bottom? So that would then refer to this being parallel to this, alternating, because of alternate interior angles are congruent. And I could not prove any other sides would be parallel. So I think by definition, we need to have at least one set of parallel sides. So I think we could say that's enough information to say it would be a trapezoid.
But like for the other pairs of sides, the right and left one, I guess.
Here and here?
So if you extend those out and then ignore the other ones that we did for both parallel, you could actually make it so those are parallel. So I thought it might be a parallelogram. But I guess it would make sense that it is a trapezoid.
And so I like how you're thinking on that, because some of that I was starting to think about is I know obviously I have this as a reflexive. So I kind of went to thinking about a triangle proof, two different triangles. And I couldn't justify to make, I had an angle on a side, an angle on a side, and it doesn't have to be hypotenuse leg or hypotenuse angle. So I don't think I can go any further. I don't think I could go to these are parallel with what I know. I'm trying to think, would that, like if that were extended?
Yeah, because then the rest,
then that's there, and that's there.
You could extend the angles that are already known to be.
Actually, that's right there.
All the way back out. But then I guess that would be extending the problem to something else.
Yeah, which is good thinking. I like it, because you're taking a logical sequence of stuff and trying to put it in order. I got to think on that a little more, because I like what your ideas are. I don't know if I can come up with a conclusion that we're good with right away. Yo, Johnny.
Can you do 13?
13. Okay. So, number 13, we have A is 0,4, B is 4,4, C is 8, negative 2, and D is 2,1. So, we want to see if A, B, C, D could be labeled as a trapezoid. And at the minimum for a trapezoid, I have to show that I have only one set of parallel sides. So I guess I could find the slope here. So that's 4 minus 4, which is 0. So the slope of AB is 0. Slope of B to C is equal to negative 2 minus that. That's negative 6. 8 minus 4, which is 4. Okay, so that's BC, and that's fine if we keep it, you know, I guess I could say, oh, that's this. So those are obviously not parallel or perpendicular sides. Then I could find the slope of CD, see if that works. 1 minus 2, so I'm going to get 3. 2 minus 8 is 6. So I get 1/2. So none of my slopes are the same or perpendicular. So then let's find A, B, C, so A to D, we need to also find that. A to D, I get 1 minus 4, which is 3. Cool. And then 2 minus 0, which is 2. So I get 3 over 2. Did I do that right? 1, oh, that should have been negative. So I have this and this being parallel. And if those two are parallel, that's all I have proven with the slope so far. I haven't done anything with distances. But I have at least one, right now I can say I have at least one set of parallel sides guaranteed. No other sides are parallel or perpendicular. So it makes sense to me to say that we have enough information right now to say that we have a trapezoid. Does that make sense? Cool. Anything else from the homework? Feel all right? Yeah.
Can you do 6?
Yeah. Solving for C. Okay. We want to solve angle C. I know that all four of them have to add up to be 180. I only know I have a trapezoid. What are some other rules about a trapezoid that I might know? Does 2x plus 13 plus 3x plus 12 have to equal 180 in a trapezoid? I know it works in an isosceles trapezoid, but a regular trapezoid. Yeah? Were you saying yeah? We have the theorem? No? You want to say? Hang on, so let's see. I want to know, do I have enough information to say those, when added together, gives me 180? So I think if we were to kind of like cut this section out right here, and I remove this angle up here, it becomes a linear pair, so I think that's enough information to say that 2x plus 13 plus 3x plus 12 is equal to 180, okay? So you have your sets of base angles, or you have your two different bases, your parallel bases, and that's going to give me 5x plus 25 equals 180. 5x, what's 180 minus 25? 155? Thank you. And x is equal to 31. And if I know that x is equal to 31, I know that all the angles have to add up to 180. So that's going to be 62 plus 13, which is 75. And then this one is 93 plus 12, which is that much? Is it 105? Is that right?
Yeah.
105 degrees. Cool. And then I know that this is 31 plus 12, which is 33, you say? 43? And then if I add 105 and 75, I get 180. 180 added to 43. And so that last side becomes 1/3. It's what? This last side is 137, or that and that adding? Oh, it's 137. Yeah, and then 137 plus 43 should be 180. Yeah, that'll work. I like it. Yeah.
So in this one, is C not equal to, well, it's obviously not, but like, isn't it the base, aren't the base angles supposed to be equal?
Only on the isosceles trapezoid.
Okay.
So think of this as a trapezoid being like this. So that's a trapezoid. It's not isosceles, and so the base angles don't have to be the same.
Okay.
Yeah. 14?
Yeah.
Using the quadrilateral as a number 13, find the lengths of the diagonals AC and BD, and then determine if ABC is an isosceles trapezoid. So if AC and BD are equal, it would be an isosceles trapezoid. Okay. So number 14, we want to find the distance of AC. Oh, Jesus. I say one thing and I write something different. I'll tell you. Typical guy. Okay, so A is 0, 4, and C is 8, negative 2. Cool. And then B is 4 comma 4, and D is 2 comma 1. And the distance formula is going to work nicely. You're going to remember that it's this. So I found the distance formula here, x1, y1, so y1, x2, y2. So let's see, 8 minus 0 quantity squared plus 8 minus 0. Negative 2 minus 4 quantity squared, that's going to be what, 64 plus 36, that's 100, so that's 10. So AC has a length of 10, so BD also has a length of 10, it's an isosceles trapezoid. So x1, y1, x2, y2, plug it into our distance formula. Let's see, 2 minus 4 quantity squared plus 1 minus 4. Quantity squared, so then that's what? Oh my gosh, that's going to come out to 4 plus, so root 13 is nowhere close to that, so I'd say we are not an isosceles trapezoid. Does that make sense? Is that what the answer says too? Oh, good. Thank goodness. I'm glad when I do things right, or I'm glad when the answers agree. What questions? Other questions, maybe? Go once, twice, sold? All right, yeah. 10? 10 we had started yesterday. I didn't have time to finish, but I'll do it for you real quick. So I'm just going to do this. I know that if I do this side plus this side and divide it in half, it will equal this side. That's the mid segment. So the top, or the right side and left side, which is top and bottom, if you wanted to say that. So that's going to give me what? 4x plus 14 divided by 2. That's equal to 3x minus 2. We could reduce that to side ID. 2x plus 7 equals 3x minus 2. Subtract that, I get x. X equals 9. And once you do that, I don't know, were we just trying to find x? Yeah, find x. Yeah. Yeah,
and for that, you can also move the 2 to the other side.
Yeah, you could have made that 6x minus 4, same thing. Perfect. Yeah. 12. 12. Did I do 12 yesterday?
Yeah.
I thought I did. It's yesterday. Okay. It's on yesterday's notes. All right. If you would, go ahead and staple, make sure your name's on your homework, and put it on that folder. And then come see me, and I'll get you a note. One, two, three. Cool. Yes. Yes. Please. There you go.
Could I have two?
Two? Sure. Right there. Need one more?
Yeah, it's one.
Surely.
Oh. I like your shirt. Thank you.
Yes. Anybody else need notes? If you need anything in notes, come grab. Anybody else going once? Everyone have a thing of notes? All right. So I'm going to try something. It's new to me, and if it's new to me, that might mean there might be an error or two as part of it. Okay? And I don't mean there to be an error, but this is going to be worth extra credit. All right, so going into this. Come on, man. All right, so going into Schoology.
Yes.
Going into Schoology, I have this due. Why do you not work? I want this to happen. So, I have something called the reaction to the reading. Okay, so, I got to see where this is at. So, I think if you go here, I think this will work. There's going to be a folder that you can go to. You click on this, and if that doesn't happen, we'll make it work. And then click on this.
Yes.
And this will take you to a website. And it's not a long article. But it talks about medicine and math. It's not really a long article at all. I think it's pretty simple to read. I mean, trust me, I've seen much longer articles that teachers give students. Like, really? 12 and a half pages back to back? So it just talks about medicine. So what I'd like you to do between now and Wednesday of next week is I'd like you to read the article and... You know, if you go and log on to Schoology and you can't find the article, email me because I might have made an error. Okay? So again, because there might be some goof-ups. But if you do that and you do put something in, you read the directions, and it's just basically reacting to a discussion amongst you guys, I will give you extra credit. Cool?
How much?
A discussion.
So you read it and then... On the Schoology, there's a reaction to it. So where is that? Is the reaction to the reading. And it just says, students are to discuss points from this article. Students are to react to at least one statement about the article. A reaction can start with. So I started with it, and I said, the ithotripter is a geometric-shaped object that, so someone can react to that. Whoever gets on there first can react to that right now. And then someone else could react to what was just stated. So you guys are building off each other's reactions from the article. Make sense? What if no one comments? Well, so if there's no one has commented yet, this can be the catalyst to start it.
Reaction of the article itself is what other people said.
Well, yeah, so I just tried to say, let's get it started here, not necessarily, you know, you might see something there that might capture your, like, oh, you know what, I heard that at my doctor's office, because there's stuff in there that you might have heard at your doctor's office when you went and just had, you know, had a checkup, or you had a, you know, sinus infection, or whatever, so, yeah. You can react off of what's based on what someone has said, or you can react off the article. Cool? So there's really not a right or wrong, and I'm not looking for a volume of events to be written, and I'm not looking for cited quotations, and I'm not looking for, you know, someone's PhD thesis, okay? I'm just looking for, you read it, you got something out of the article, you went with it. Cool? And if you decide you want to do it, it's worth extra credit. I will put this into the test category, extra credit. Does it matter? It's like, he just went real. I'll put it in the final exam category. How's that sound? So that means everyone's grade looks really kick butt because the final exam is worth, you know, like 30% of your grade. And then all of a sudden you have a perfect score in there. It's like, Mom, I got an A in math. Failed every test. I'm kidding. All right, you ready? Ready for it? Kites. Ooh. This is, so the things that people fly are called kites as well. And that's what the shapes stem from. And the kite is called the kite for whatever reason. But the mathematical properties that go along with the kite is actually why it does fly. So that's kind of cool. So develop and understand the definition of properties of quadrilaterals that are kites. First, a review of question. Find X and Y. All right, so what do you think? Where should we go on this problem? What should I draw in first? Auxiliary lines. I'm going to draw this height in right here. Does that help everybody? If I know that this distance over here is 5, then what's the height right here? 5. And I know that this distance here to here would be how much? 6. So this is a 30, 60, 90. Okay, so opposite of the 30, I have 5. So the hypotenuse has to be what? What's the hypotenuse? It's 10. Good. So there's our y value there. Okay, so the opposite of the 30 is always half of the hypotenuse, and the hypotenuse is always twice the side of the opposite of 30. So what does the side down here have to be then? 5 root 3. So that means that 5 root 3 added to 6 is going to give me 5 root 3 plus 6, and that's equal to x. There you go. Is that okay? So the trick on there is realizing I need to draw on the auxiliary line, aka a height. And then 3690. If it wasn't a 3690 or a 45-45-90, other things you could have done to find this, if you knew this and you wanted to find that as well, is you could have used, you know, sine and cosine and tangent. And those would have worked as well. Cool? All right, moving on. Kite. We have some definition. Quadrilateral with two distinct pairs of congruent adjacent sides. Wait, one more time. Quadrilateral with two distinct pairs of congruent, that means they're the same size, adjacent means they're right next to each other, sides. So this side here, whoops, this side here and this side here are the same. But this side here and this side here. So is this congruent and adjacent?
Yes.
Is this congruent and adjacent?
Yes.
Are these congruent and adjacent?
No.
Neither. So quadrilateral with two distinct pairs of congruent adjacent sides. Okay? Concave is this one because you create the cave, and then obviously convex. With all everything pointing outward. Good so far? I like kites. We should have built kites when I was at home today. It was windy enough this morning. What, make it extra credit? I'm already giving you one extra credit thing. I guess there's a fulcrum point of points that you're willing to versus not willing to. I get it. I understand how you roll.
We didn't get it.
Here, we'll do this. We'll do this for the extra credit. I bet you we would have 100% do this. The first person who posts gets the most extra credit, and then the next person gets the next most.
Really?
Actually,
no, I don't.
Kids are like, kids are taking Chromebooks. Give me your Chromebook and talk. Come on, buddy.
Do they really?
Yeah,
oh, that's so cool. Who is that? Oh, that's so awesome.
First person to finish the crossword gets extra credit, and everybody just runs up and pushes each other over.
Oh, yeah. You know, kid running around with a pencil sticking out of his ear. Ah, I'm so talking.
I don't even try. I don't even try.
It's like, you guys ever heard Brian Regan, the comedian? Talks about the spelling bee. You guys with me? You ever hear his skit? He talks about the spelling bee, you know, when you're in elementary school. All right, class, line up in front of the room. First one to get it wrong has to sit down. So you had that one kid thinking, okay, I'm going to roll the dice that I get the right answer, but he's really the, you know, not the brightest. But then you got the kid who's kind of the brightest, but just doesn't want to waste time because he realizes it doesn't mean anything. So he purposely spells it wrong, so he goes and sits down. He's like, okay, Johnny, you run the spelling bee last year. Okay, you ready? Cat. K-A-T. Cat, I'm out. And then as the kid goes and sits down, I know there's two T's. Serious. If you haven't heard Brian Regan, I recommend it. He's like, pretty. Okay, Brian, what's the I before E rule? It's I before E.
Except after seeing, except for saying like way, like a neighbor's in way.
You'll always have it wrong no matter what you say. All right. Can we prove the diagonals are perpendicular? Can we prove the diagonals are perpendicular? What else did we prove at the same time? Oh, I don't know. So let's see. If this is congruent to this, and this is congruent to this, and this base angle and this base angle have to be the same, yes? And then this and this would have to be the same, because that's the whole definition of isosceles, because you have, basically, you would have this isosceles triangle here, right? And this isosceles down here, right? Okay, so I don't know if that's going to help us, but let's get rid of the highlighted stuff. It's on the video in case you want to do that. What else can we say about these? I see something. What about this? What about this triangle here and this triangle here? What can you tell me about these two triangles? Yeah, I have the reflexive property, so are the two triangles congruent?
Yes.
Yeah, so the long triangles are congruent because of side, side, side. So let me get rid of all the highlight stuff. Okay, so then if I know that, that's going to mean that this angle here and this angle here are the same because of CPCTC, right? And then if I state that, then I can say that this triangle here and this triangle here are congruent because of CPCTC, or because of angle side angle. Okay, so if I can do that, that means that this angle here and this angle here are identical. And if you know that, you can do these angles are identical because of vertical angles, right? And so then I have four congruent angles, and four congruent angles are perpendicular to each other. They form 90 degrees. So that right there will tell us that we've proved. So there's a lot you could prove with this. So we're able to use triangles similarity, but then you get to saying, hey, these all have to be 90 degrees because I have four congruent angles that all converge at one point. Love it. All right. Ooh, we got hidden stuff up here. Just move down. If a quadrilateral is a kite, then the longer diagonal, is the perpendicular bisector of the shorter diagonal. Okay, wait. So the two diagonals are the perpendicular bisectors of each other, actually. And we could have went back and proved that very easily on here, saying, well, I know this and this and this. Oh, wait. So wait a minute. This right here and this right here are the same. Agreed? But I can't go here and here. So that theorem, if a quadrilateral is a kite, then the longer diagonal is the perpendicular bisector to the shorter diagonal. So it'll cut the shorter diagonal into two equal parts, and it will form 90 degrees.
Cool. I like that rule. Where are we at? Cool. Almost done. Too sweet.
Yeah. Can I move on? Anyone still copying? All right. How can we prove that one pair of opposite angles are congruent? How can we prove that one pair of opposite angles are congruent? Well, I'm just going to take a shot in the dark saying, hey, if I make that, then I know that. So that triangle on top and that triangle on bottom are congruent to each other because of side. And then I can say that this angle here and this angle here are congruent because of?
CBCCC.
Yeah, CBCCC. Sweet. Gosh, this is cool. This is all starting to come together for me. I think I'm ready for Accelerated Algebra 2 next year.
Could you?
Yeah, will you actually?
I don't know. I mean, I have to graduate from this class first. And if I were to do that, that would mean I have to teach like some of you. And then others would be like, dude, it's not fair. You know, you're stuck with stirrup and I got a better teacher. So, you know, that might not be a good idea. Some kid crying himself to sleep. Hey, Mr. Stirrup. It happens. Don't worry. I have people who hate me, I'm sure. All right. Let's do this. If a quadrilateral is a kite, then one pair of opposite angles are congruent. Okay? A quadrilateral is a kite, then one pair of opposite angles are congruent. Does it say that both of them? No. You all doing all right? Hey, did you guys all see the runaway truck catch air?
Where?
Oh. So a guy got pulled over. And so the cop is talking to the person. The passenger jumps over to the driver's seat, takes off. 115-mile-an-hour chase. So they're doing a police roadblock. Well, the guy who's driving the truck puts it down in the ditch, comes over and catches air. I'm talking, he probably launched twice as tall as this roof, and at least from here to Union Avenue in the air, his truck.
Was it the black truck?
Yeah, it was a black truck. Yeah, so. And at the end of the news report, there was a car that it landed on, and there was a person in the car, and everybody walked away with not a scratch. Like, oh, yeah, I'm fine. So I think that needs to have, like, you know, the Dukes of Hazzard scene or something. Just a good old
one. When was it?
Yesterday. It's on the news right
in
now.
Colorado?
I don't know where it happened. I don't think it's Colorado. Oh, wow. Way too green. Like, when you see it, you're like, oh, there's way too much green. But, I mean, it's a good air. I mean, I'll tell you what, if you're gonna go out, that guy went out in style.
And did he get arrested?
Oh, I'm sure he spent a little time. I have no idea. They didn't say any of that. I was more amazed by the truck jumping. I thought that was kind of cool. But I'm that kind of guy. I'm sorry. All right. Find the measures of F and D. Find the measures of F and D. So things that we would be able to know is I could draw in that auxiliary line. I could prove this triangle over here and this triangle over here are congruent because of side. So this angle here and this angle here have to be the exact same thing. Well, it is a four-sided object, therefore, the sum of the angles has to be 360. So if I call that x and I call that x, because d and f are the exact same thing, so let d equal x and let f equal d. f equal x. So I know that 2x plus 124 plus 180 equals, thank you, equals 360. And then I don't know what it comes out to. Someone's got something fancy to do that math. What'd you get? Is it really?
78, yeah.
78? Yeah. Okay. Sweet. So if that's 78, that's 78. And I know that all... So, again, that goes along if it's a kite. So if you were to prove this and this are equal, boom, kite. Why is kite? Because here, quadrilateral is a kite, then there's one pair of opposite angles congruent. Yeah?
Does it matter which pair?
I don't think you would prove these ones would be equal because of just how the shape would be. And if you did, it's no longer going to be a kite because I'm pretty sure... If these happen to be equal, then something more is going to start taking place. All right, find x. Found it. All right. Ooh, this kind of like takes us back to the last section. What do you know that to be? There it is, the geometric mean. Whoa. All right, so I'm going to call that smiley face. There you go. So 9 over smiley face is equal to smiley face over 4. So smiley face squared equals 36. So smiley face is equal to 6. So if that's 6, then I could find x by using what theorem? Yeah, because then all of a sudden I know that that's 90 degrees, right? Pythagorean theorem, so I get 6 squared plus 4 squared equals x squared. So that's 36 plus 16 equals x squared. X equals root 52. I guess we should break that down. That breaks down to 4 times 1, 13. So that becomes 2 root 13 as an exact answer. Oh, that was cool. Yeah.
I just did x over 4.
Over 4. Yeah, that would work too. X over 4 equals 13 over 8. That's breaking those triangles. Good job. Good deal. I like it. Was that it?
Yeah.
That's it. Time out. All right. So, ladies and gentlemen, 8.6. So, 8.6 worksheet is due tomorrow. And then the optional Schoology will be due on when? 1 week from today. Wednesday next week. Cool? Yeah. Yep, let me stop the video.